Good morning, everybody. I'm going to present to you material referring to get, take, and gerunds after prepositions. Let's start with the meaning of take. Take means llevar, and robar, sacar, tomar algo. Take is used when something moves from one place to another. Significa llevar, tomar, recoger algo a alguien y llevar a ese algo a alguien a otro lugar. Here we have some examples, and it says, don't forget to take your sunglasses if you go skiing. Take it with you. What time do you take Emmy to school? It means llevar a Emmy a la escuela. Take in a the meaning of robar o tomar algo. Here we have some examples, and it says, if you want more information, please take a leaflet. So it means, si quiere más información, tome un volante, por favor. Someone's taken my wallet. That man has taken my car. And please take a leaflet. Por favor, tome un panfleto, un volante, un folleto. Get. Get tiene varios significados, más del principal, que es traer o bring. Dependiendo del contexto, puede ser recoger, obtener, llegar, alcanzar. These are the main ones. Get have many other meanings. Here we have some examples. She got all her money from her father. Obtuvo el dinero de su padre. I got a phone call. Recibí una llamada. I pick up my mother from the airport. Recogí a mi madre. Where can I get the best sushi in Santiago? Comprar. Where did you get la guitar? Sacaste, obtuviste. And Pedro got very late home last night. Llegar, llegó. Get can have a meaning of fetch. Fetch is ir a buscar algo. And it is used to talk about something that is going to be bring it back. And here we have some examples with that use of get. She get to fetch help, or she went to get help, and the meaning is the same. Ella fue a buscar ayuda. He went to fetch the children from school, or he went to get the children from school. Same meaning again. Fue a buscar a los niños al colegio. Fetch has a meaning of traer. Fetch me the hammer o get me the hammer. Again, same meaning. Tráeme un martillo. Could you fetch me the magazine from the kitchen? Or could you get me the magazine from the kitchen? ¿Me puedes traer la revista de la cocina? Here we have material in referring to gerunds after prepositions. This is just a general rule. My friends, always, always, it is a gerund after a preposition. After every preposition of any preposition, it must be a gerund. This is the only rule in here, not exceptions at all. It says, if a verb is used after a preposition, it must be a gerund, which functions as a noun. And it is impossible to use an infinitive after a preposition. General rule. It is one rule, not exceptions. Here we have an example and it says, I will call you after arriving at the office. Never, you can say this, I will call after to arrive at the office. This is not correct. Here are some examples. Please have a drink before leaving. I'm looking forward to meeting you. This is the preposition before, to, and about. And after prepositions, always gerunds. Leaving, meeting, working, going. Here are some other prepositions, as you can see, and some examples with that. Please, I suggest you to have a look at this one and practice.